Καλημέρα στην Ελλάδα από την Ναυτική Ακαδημία της Βάρνας. Είμαστε εδώ για να σας ενημερώσουμε και να σας δείξουμε πώς είναι η Ναυτική Ακαδημία και πώς είναι η ζωή στη Βάρνα. Η Ναυτική Ακαδημία της Βάρνας, Naval Navtcharov, είναι η παλαιότερη τεχνική σχολή της Βουλγαρίας με ένδοξη ιστορία από το 1881. Λόγω του ένδοξου παρελθόντος και της παράδοσης στην εκπαίδευση των εμποροπλοιάρχων και των μηχανικών. Είναι η πρώτη ναυτική σχολή στη Βουλγαρία από το 1881 που εκπαιδεύει μηχανικούς τόσο στο πολεμικό όσο και στο εμπορικό ναυτικό. Καλημέρα στην Ελλάδα. Βρισκόμαστε εδώ για να σας ενημερώσουμε για την Ναυτική Ακαδημία της Βάρνας και για τη ζωή στη Βάρνα. Η Ναυτική Ακαδημία Navtcharov είναι γνωστή για το ένδοξο παρελθόν της, διότι από το 1881 προετοιμάζει τόσο και εκπαιδεύει εμποροπλοιάρχους και μηχανικούς, τόσο για το εμπορικό όσο και για το πολεμικό ναυτικό.
Καλημέρα και από μένα. Σε ολόκληρη την Ελλάδα, από την Ναυτική Ακαδημία της Βάρνας. Βρισκόμαστε σήμερα εδώ για να δείξουμε στους Έλληνες φοιτητές τόσο τη ζωή, όσο και τις σπουδές, το επίπεδο σπουδών που παρέχει η Ναυτική Ακαδημία. Εκπροσωπούμε την Ναυτική Ακαδημία τα 8 τελευταία χρόνια και θέλουμε να έρθουμε πιο κοντά και στους φοιτητές που βρίσκονται ήδη στην Ακαδημία, αλλά και στους Έλληνες φοιτητές που θα μας επιλέξουν για τις σπουδές τους, για τη ζωή τους από το Σεπτέμβριο του 2015 και τα επόμενα χρόνια.
Είμαστε εδώ με τον πρίτανη της Ακαδημίας, Νικολάη Βελίκο.
Honestly speaking, we are very, very happy to have students from Greece here. And this is some new tension for us, and I am sure that my colleague and I promise, and I will try to do our best to provide good condition for the training and for the study.
Thank you. We are very pleased that we came here to bring to Greek students the quality of study that you provide here in your university. Many people already know that you provide this quality to Greek students. Very often we communicate with parents and they tell us that they are very satisfied for your support, okay? And especially in difficult situations during their studies. So thank you. Thank you for your
I know support. That now you are preparing special film, special
yes.
advertising movie, presentation of our Naval
yes.
Academy.
We tend to communicate it to TV, okay? So thank you for your support. Can you please tell us a few words about
Absolutely.
The programs and the studies?
Okay, in Bulgaria? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Here you are.
Уважаеми гръцки студенти, искам да ви поздравя с вашият интелигентен избор и интересът, който проявявате към Висшето военноморско училище Никола Йонков от Царов. Нашето училище е най-старото техническо учебно заведение в Република България. То има и много голям международен престиж. Дипломите на нашето училище са международно признати от 1960 година и в наши дни хиляди наши възпитаници плават на кораби под флаговите на десетки държави и разнасят славата на нашето училище. Ние се гордеем с високото ниво на подготовката, което осигурява нашето училище. Това ниво на подготовка е потвърдено и от множеството международни одити, през които преминаваме. През миналата година нашето училище бе сертифицирано изключително успешно от Европейската агенция за морска безопасност, ЕМСА, а така също и от Японското министерство на транспорта. Ние имаме много специални връзки между нашите възпитаници, и се надяваме, че много скоро сред тях ще бъдат и представители на Република Гърция. Надявам се, че настоящият филм ще ви даде достатъчно информация и вие ще можете да направите своят избор да се присъедините към Висшето военноморско училище Никола Йонков в Царев.
Can you tell us, please, why the university is not on the list of recognition, and what movements have you done to be in the list of recognition? What up, I mean.
The maritime education is regulated by European Maritime Safety Agency and International Maritime Organization using the FTCW Convention. IMO prepared a special so-called white list of universities and institutions which provide high-level quality education, and our Naval Academy is part of this. To be part of this system, you should be under control of national maritime administrations and some international bodies as EMSA. So we are in this list since 1960, and after the last edition of the list in the beginning of 90s. Mm-hmm. And according to this, we are passing different audits by our National Maritime Administration, and especially by European Maritime Safety Agency, which is responsible for the control of maritime education in European Union.
How many students can the university educate for this year? The positions, I mean. Mm-hmm.
In this year, we have in our university more than 2,600 students. About 100 of them are naval cadets for the Bulgarian and Vietnamese Navy. Mm-hmm. And other part of our trainees are students for the merchant marines. In our academy, we have representatives of 10 nations and more than 100 foreign students, and I hope that this number will go up.
This present to you from our company.
Thank you very much. Flex University. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Naval Academy information.
Thank you very much.
For information included.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. I wish you success with the Black Sea University. And hope that we'll have many, many, hundred students here. And I think that this is very, very good challenge for us and good opportunity for our friends from Greece to have maritime education.
Thank you again.
Hello, we are now locating in one of our small and good laboratories where EGDIS, so-called electronic chart display and information system, labs are conducting. This is a special designed laboratory where type-specific training of EGDIS systems is conducted. This particular room is dedicated to the Japanese company JRC, one of the producers of EGDIS systems. Lots of ships all over the world are equipped with that. So for this purpose, I mean for type-specific training, we have to be equipped, and we are equipped with some specific EGDIS systems, such as this one that you are seeing, and others are Furuno and Raytheon.
Here we have the GRC model 701-2000 JAM 901B. They are the so-called old models. I mean, since last year, November, the GRC produced the new model, which is shown here on this screen. There are 7201 and 9201. The main difference is that the old models of GRC use the Windows XP system. The new model is already with the Windows 7, which of course you know is much more better. XP no more is supported. There are new features in the 9201, which are better than the old models JAM 2000 and 901B.
Will you intend to bring another equipment or last technology equipment? Will you intend to bring it?
Well, I can say that today we have pretty much state-of-the-art technologies relating to the maritime training. But in the future, we have a responsibility to update all the simulators or the technical equipment to match the requirements, especially to IMO and EMSA. So I should say, yes, we update it all the time. This is a current process that never ends. And of course, we'll do that for the future.
May I ask you, in which academic year a student start this training? And how do you help students in this training? Simulator.
Okay, students start this training, this type of training, from the very beginning.
In the first academic year?
Yes, okay. But the first year the training is more basic, something that is to be familiar with the situation, and the specific training is going third and fourth year, especially fourth year. After the students come back from the ship training practice, cadetship practice, they are much more practically trained. They know much more about the navigation, the sailing. So this is the time when this type of simulator could be used effectively. And especially for bridge team management, of course, and for resource team management, bridge resource management course, which is very important and required by STCW convention, which is setting up the standards for training about the seafarers. Now we are in one of our simulators, which are produced by Transas. We have four like this, and also we have another bridge simulator, which is produced by Vistep. So these five simulators are extensively used for training the students and to provide postgraduate training courses. Again, I should say about bridge team management, and bridge resource management, maneuvering, and seamanship.
Do the students find a difficulty in this phase of training? This kind of simulation?
Okay, I should say that those of our students who had studied theoretically well before the simulator don't find it difficult. And the most important role of such a simulator is, after theoretical studying, to be able to implement everything in practice. So I don't think this is difficult. This is this is done to facilitate the training of the student. So I should answer, it is not difficult.
Okay.
And now let me just say a few words about the simulator equipment. We have here three displays. This one is the radar. This one is the conning display, so-called conning display. And this one is the electronic chart. These three displays give the necessary information for the student and for the group, the crew, to control the ship.
I'm sure that the students find it amazing, all this experience. Do you agree?
Yes, I agree, absolutely agree. This is maybe one of the most amusing part of their training, because the simulator is a fun.
Mm-hmm.
This is not only training, but it is a fun.
Mm-hmm. This is the office, the secretary, where our students make the registration here in the academy.
We are now locating in the main foyer of the Naval Academy. Just behind me, there is the patron of the Naval Academy, Nicola Votava. And also, this is the official session room of the Naval Academy. And also the administration area of the academy. The navigation faculty is located on my left side. The engineering faculty is on my right side.
So you are waiting 100 students for this academic year. Are you ready for this?
Yes, we are. I want to explain why. Next month, we're receiving accreditation procedure from the Bulgarian accreditation agency. During the process of inspecting our programs, especially the program navigation we'll be inspecting, we're going to apply for increasing the so-called capacity of the Naval Academy relating in this particular program, navigation. So we'll show to the agency how much students places we have, how much working places we have, and they will decide to increase our capacity. So we can accept 100 students, that's for sure. Now welcome again to the, this time to the engineering faculty of the Naval Academy. We are locating in one of our newest engine room simulators. Since I am not a ship engineer, I cannot say a lot of details about this, but I will ask my colleague Lieutenant Bakalov to say something more about the simulator.
Hello everyone. My name is Ivailo Bakalov. I'm assistant of this department, Ship Power Plant. Here we are in the one simulator, engine room simulator 5000. This simulator has been developed and distributed by Transas, Russian company, as a system for training and development of skills of watchkeeping for engine room personnel, like a chief engineer, second engineer and electrical engineer. The idea for this simulator is to check of knowledge of the personnel, like for example, electrical engineer sit here and he maintains the auxiliary system and electrical system for the ship power plant. Here sit the chief engineer, and he watched and maintained the main engine for in the ship.
How do they find it? Do they find it difficult to study this?
Yes, but here we study two kinds of people, students and people who travel and maintain the
knowledge.
Maintain the knowledge. And for these people who has all years for in the ship. We check different kind of troubles. The instructor sits here and we make a, for example,
scenarios,
yes. When we teach the students, we teach, for example, what is the separator, what is the main engine, what is the diesel generator,
basic
knowledge. And also here we have, for example, analyzing for exhaust gas analyzing, and we have mnemonic diagram for the mechanisms in the engine room. This simulator has three kind of ships, three type of ships: military frigate type Anzac. We have product tanker and passenger ship. This have three type of our engine room simulator.
Because there are no exercises currently.
Okay,
the students are preparing for exams. What
can we say? Can we give some information about this?
So what are you seeing here is a centrifugal fuel separator used to improve the quality of the heavy and light and light marine diesel oil to remove the contamination and to prepare it for usage in marine diesel engines. As you see, there are a lot of pumps and pumping system in our laboratory, so that our students what I wanted to say is that our yes, there are a lot of piping system. Actually, our laboratory, there is a lot of real equipment in our laboratories, that's only a part of it. But we are relating it to Alfa Laval because this equipment is sent as a gift to the academy from the company. But we are having a lot of other real equipment. We have a real steering gear, a real refrigeration plant, a real air conditioning plant. We have working medium speed diesel engines in the basement. There are a lot of compartments in the basement which are equipped
downstairs.
So we are using it to provide our students with real access so that they can get used to the sounds, to the real actions, so that they're used with it when they go on board ships. Because the contact with machinery is not very intuitive. And it's really important to us that they're used to work and to operate the real machinery, to know what are the procedures they should go through to prepare the equipment and to start it or to shut it down. Another centrifugal separator, again it's not very clean, it's a bit messy, but we are. So it's a bit of a combination between a lecture room and some machinery space. Here we have a four-round steering gear. It's operating. It is in operation. We have also some deck equipment. It's not in operation, but it visualizes the actual size and the actual machinery. We have winches, we have windlasses, and so on, pumping equipment. Here in the inner rooms are the refrigeration plant and the air conditioning plant.
In which academy year do you use all these machines?
Pardon?
In which academy year?
And in our in the third when we are talking about the engineering specialties. Mm-hmm. In the sixth and the in the fifth and the sixth semester, yes.
Now in front of our broker's classroom. This is a special designed room to conduct ship broker's courses according to the agreement that we have with the London Institute of Chartered Ship Brokers. This is a good opportunity for our students to take we have a license to conduct 7 courses on behalf of the London Ship Brokers Institute, and this is a good opportunity for our students to get that broker's courses and to apply for membership in the London Institute of Chartered Ship Brokers. All these books are separate courses.
So this is the material you provide the students for this course?
Okay. The course is conducted entirely in English language. And these are our future brokers. By the way, there is a similar broker center in Athens. So Greek students may choose Athens or Varna if they prefer. As I said before, Naval Academy has been licensed to conduct 7 of the all amount of courses that London Chartered Ship Brokers presents. For example, mm-hmm. we provide this one, dry cargo chartering, but not this one.
Okay.
For membership, 7 courses are enough. So, Greek guys, please come to our broker's courses if you want, or go in Athens. There are another center there. I just want to mention that because we raised this question, our Naval Academy, we consider our activities regarding the Greek students as another option that we give them, because we fully understand that they first will apply in Greece.
Mm-hmm.
This is absolutely clear. But if some of the guys is not accepted, he has another option, another opportunity to come and to apply in Varna. Instead of just living his dreams about the sea.
Of course. Mm. Right.
So this is a Naval Academy is second option for them.
Mm-hmm.
But not the first one. I understand that the first is the Greek Academy. Am I right? You are about the end of your first year, right?
Yes.
So, can you please inform me what happens with your second semester? How all of you is ending the semester? Is there any problems with the mathematics? Is there any problems with informatics? What of exams have already passed? What is in front of you? Do you have any considerations, any concerns about some of the examinations? Just you may share this opinion with me.
Συνεχίζοντας λοιπόν την ξενάγησή μας σήμερα στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία της Βάρνας, θέλω να ρωτήσουμε τα παιδιά που ζουν, που είναι από το Σεπτέμβριο του 2014 μέσα, να μας πούν κάποια πράγματα σχετικά με την εμπειρία τους, βοηθώντας έτσι και τους φοιτητές και τα παιδιά που σκέφτονται να ανέβουν στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία από το Σεπτέμβριο του 2015. Κωνσταντίνε, πες μου λίγο έτσι για τη ζωή σου στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία.
Η ζωή στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία είναι... Η ζωή στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία είναι πάρα πολύ ωραία. Τα μαθήματα είναι πολύ καλά, οι καθηγητές βοηθάνε πάρα πολύ. Σαν ζωή γενικά στην πόλη είναι πολύ όμορφη η αθλητική ζωή. Έχει βάλει πάρα πολλούς φοιτητές από διάφορα μέρη της Ελλάδας. Στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία είμαστε κοντά στους 50 Έλληνες πρωτοετής. Και γενικά η ζωή είναι πάλι πολύ ωραία και πολύ φθηνή.
Πες μου λίγο, Μάρια, πώς επέλεξες να έρθεις να σπουδάσεις στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία. Γνωρίζοντας, με συγχωρείς, ότι στην Ελλάδα σήμερα με την οικονομική κρίση υπάρχουν προβλήματα, για να σπουδάσει κάποιος πιο μακριά από τον τόπο καταγωγής του είναι εξαιρετικά δύσκολο και οικονομικά δυσβάστακτο για τον Έλληνα φοιτητή. Πες μου λίγο πώς επέλεξες την Ναυτική Ακαδημία στην Βάρνα.
Εγώ που έρχομαι από ναυτική οικογένεια, ο πατέρας μου είναι μηχανικός εμπορικού ναυτικού, την ήξερε τη σχολή και επειδή το κόστος διαβίωσης εδώ πάνω είναι φτηνό, ήταν μια πάρα πολύ καλή λύση για εμένα που το όνειρό μου είναι να ασχοληθώ με την ναυτιλία.
Πες μου επίσης τι θέλεις, Μάρια, σε παιδιά που σκέφτονται σήμερα, που τελειώνουν σήμερα τρίτη λυκείου και σκέφτονται να ζουν, τους αρέσει το κομμάτι της ναυτιλίας και σκέφτονται να ακολουθήσουν τις ναυτιλιακές σπουδές.
Τι θα ήθελα να πω, για...
Τι θα έλεγες στα παιδιά που σήμερα είναι τρίτη λυκείου ή και μεγαλύτερα και σκέφτονται να ακολουθήσουν ναυτιλιακές σπουδές και πόσο μάλλον στην Ναυτική Ακαδημία στην
Βάρνα. Θα ήταν μια πάρα πολύ καλή επιλογή, επειδή η σχολή είναι αναγνωρισμένη και η εκπαίδευση είναι πάρα πολύ καλή.
Πες μου λίγο, υπάρχει υποστήριξη από τους καθηγητές?
Βεβαίως υπάρχει, ό,τι ζητήσουμε το μας το δίνουν, έξτρα πληροφορίες. Η παράδοση είναι πάρα πολύ καλά, οι καθηγητές μιλάνε πολύ καλά αγγλικά.
Θέλω να σου ρωτήσω κάτι άλλο σχετικά με την εξυπηρέτηση που είχες από την πρώτη μέρα που ήρθες στη Βάρνα από την εταιρεία Black Sea University.
Ήταν άψογη η εξυπηρέτηση, με καθοδήγησαν στα πρώτα μου βήματα στην πόλη, επειδή δεν είχα ξαναέρθει. Ό,τι του ζήτησα μου το έδωσαν.
Μπράβο, χαίρομαι ιδιαίτερα γιατί ξέρετε, πηγαίνοντας σε ένα ξένο τόπο, σε ένα ξένο μέρος, θέλεις να έχεις έναν άνθρωπο όσο γίνεται συνέχεια μαζί σου.
Αυτό το είχαμε κάθε στιγμή
που ζήτησα. Είναι πολύ βασικό, το γραφείο μας βρίσκεται από εδώ σε πολύ μικρή απόσταση και θέλω οποιαδήποτε στιγμή, τα 4 χρόνια των σπουδών σου, οποιαδήποτε στιγμή γνωρίζεις ότι μπορεί να είμαστε εκεί, ακόμα και με ένα τηλέφωνο στην Ελλάδα, είτε εδώ, να λυθεί οποιοδήποτε πρόβλημα, οτιδήποτε προκύψει. Γιατί δεν ξέρουμε στα 4 χρόνια τι μπορεί να, τι ερωτήσει, τι μπορεί να μας προκύψει. Η βοήθεια όμως είναι να ξέρετε όλοι σας ότι υπάρχει οποιαδήποτε στιγμή.
Όσες φορές χρειαστήκαμε βοήθεια, μπορώ να πω ότι την είχαμε.
Σε πολλούς τομείς. Και σε μαθήματα και σε ζωή μας.
Πες μου, Κωνσταντίνε, έτσι αν έχεις σκεφτεί σχετικά με την ανέλυξή σου για τις σπουδές σου, για μετά το τέλος από εδώ.
Μετά από εδώ τη σχολή...
Παρέχεται δυνατότητα μεταπτυχιακών.
Παρέχεται δυνατότητα μεταπτυχιακών από τη σχολή με Πανεπιστήμιο του Greenwich. Και το πτυχίο είναι αρκετά πιο φτηνό από το να πάει κάποιος στην Αγγλία που θέλει αρκετό σεβαστό, ένα σεβαστό ποσό και οι καθηγητές είναι πολύ καλύτεροι σε συγκρίση με κάποια άλλα.
Έχεις επιλέξει τον τομέα του μηχανικού, έτσι.
Ναι.
Σου εύχομαι καλή επιτυχία μέσα από την καρδιά μου. Είστε από τα παιδιά που πραγματικά χαίρομαι να βοηθάω, παιδιά που ξεκινήσαμε με ένα τηλέφωνο τη συνεργασία μας και τελικά φτάσαμε εδώ που φτάσαμε. Σας εύχομαι το όνειρό σας, αυτό που έχετε σκεφτεί, να γίνει πραγματικότητα. Είναι δύσκολες εποχές, είναι εξαιρετικά δύσκολα, αλλά κάντε το βήμα. Συγχαρητήρια και σε εσάς και στις οικογένειές σας, γιατί δεν είναι εύκολο σήμερα. Καταρχήν σας στηρίζουν, αλλά να ξέρετε ότι και εμείς από την πλευρά μας κάνουμε πραγματικά ό,τι μπορούμε καλύτερο. Οποιαδήποτε στιγμή είμαστε αρρωγοί στην προσπάθεια αυτή εδώ που κάνουμε.
Ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ.
Το ξέρουμε και σας εκτιμούμε ιδιαίτερως.
Να είστε καλά, να είστε καλά. Χάρηκα πάρα πολύ. Καλή συνέχεια σπουδές.
This is a gift for you, for your help.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for your information and for your support to our Greek students.
You are welcome. And I also want to thank you about your support for the Naval Academy. I hope that we'll continue to work together. And we highly appreciate that you help Greek guys, Greek young people to acquire information about the Naval Academy. This is the most important thing for us.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Again.